UK shares remained out of luck today, Friday the 13th, in a dire week for global equity markets. Investors remain concerned worldwide by US fiscal stimulus policy as the end of the Fed's asset purchase program is in sight. And RSA Insurance was the main drag on the FTSE this morning after the company announced its CEO, Simon Lee, has resigned following further bad news for the insurer. After the recent storms that hit the UK and Northern Europe, RSA revealed this morning it would have to inject a total of £200 million into its Irish business following a review of its reserves. Martin Scicluna, the group's chairman, said he has ordered a full review of the group's businesses. Shares fell over 15% in first dealings. Among mid-caps now, Bellway was under scrutiny after the house builder said in an interim statement that appetite for new homes remains solid. John Watson, the group's chairman, said Bellway has continued to see strong customer demand for new homes, aided by low interest rates and wider accessibility to higher loan-to-value mortgages. The average number of active outlets has increased by 5%, and reservations net of cancellations have risen by 43% compared to the same period last year. In the small caps universe now, all eyes were on Victoria Oil and Gas after its long-running dispute with RSM over the Logbaba oil field in Cameroon was resolved. A court has decided that RSM did not automatically forfeit its interest in the license, as Victoria had argued. RSM must now pay the second cash call promptly or risk a further default. Elsewhere, Angle plc was supported by news it has sold its computer games graphics business for £6.2 million to iPad chip designer Arm Holdings. The move is part of the company's renewed focus as a specialist medtech company, raising funds to help develop its Parsortix non-invasive cancer diagnostics business, the market for which is estimated to be worth more than £6 million a year. Gasol, meanwhile, was upbeat about the potential of its West African LNG project in Benin, as it posted half-year results. Once the project is established, there will be multiple opportunities to secure further gas offtake agreements with minimal further capital expenditure, it said. Highlights of the half-yearly report include the $100 million bond instrument, which was listed in Ireland in August with $20 million of those bonds fully subscribed. There was also some encouraging news for Rurelec after hydroelectric subsidiary Cascade has been awarded three new power purchase agreements in Peru. Rurelec added it was a complete vindication of its decision to enter three high-priced bids. And that's the main news for today, Friday the 13th of December.